still feel something.
I look at you and I see nothing. Not the beautiful girl I fell in love with. Not the mother of my child. Not even the hateful monster you pretend to be. You're just empty. I look at you and I feel nothing. It scares the hell out of me.
You forgot to say how hideous I am. God, I know you want to. Disgusted with me, admit it!
Right, I am disgusted with you. But it has nothing to do with the way you look. I'm disgusted with what you let it do to you. How you let it change you.
Princess. Princess, wake up. I need you to get dressed real quick. There are men coming. Some very bad men. They want to take you away from me, but I won't let them. We won't let them, will we?
Yes, now I remember. Throughout all the chaos and misery, in his own flawed and misguided way, he did love her after all. His way of expressing it was a different matter altogether. Huh. I don't remember that being there. I can hear you out there. Please, please help me. It hurts. Oh, it hurts so much. I can't take it anymore. Why won't you help me? Oh, you're just like your father. You don't care about me. You probably wish I was dead.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark. And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye.
Keep your head straight! Look at me!
As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye. And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end of her. The princess heard a fearsome growl. The witch had unleashed her familiar, the hellhound. The monster slipped to the earth. Its The princess remained motionless, letting the monster pass. There was a stillness in the air. The princess breathed a sigh of relief.
Do you want this story to have a happy ending or not?
Oh, God damn it! Not again! Fine! Because the princess wouldn't stop fidgeting, she was set upon by the evil witch's minion and dragged off into the darkness, never to be seen again. The end.
My fault. It was always my fault. All I had to do was stay still, day after day, for hours on end, until he would finally get it right. I've lost count of how many attempts there were, but each one made me feel like I was his greatest failure. I don't know what I expected to find. A farewell note? A final will? What I found was an apology. Expressed in the only language he ever truly knew. At that moment, I could finally see my father for what he was. A man driven insane with sadness and guilt. Trapped in this house, a nightmarish echo chamber of past mistakes and tragedies. It was this house, a place beyond hope, beyond redemption. I knew what I had to do. I had given up trying to understand my father a long time ago. But I could finally forgive him. Hey, Princess. What have you got there? Oh, that's so lovely, sweetie. But why pink?